given a constitutional duty to see that there are free and fair elections held. Also, they have to ensure that there is a level playing field amongst all the political parties. Now, Chapter 7, the Part 7 that Mr. Trajan de Mello referred to, is that no ad hoc appointments is to be done. As per the manual given by the Election Commission of India, in 2.1 of the manual, the Election Commission states that the role of the parties in power is those directions issued in the Election Code of Conduct, at the Model Code of Conduct, as far as the role of the parties in power is the flesh and blood of the Model Code of Conduct as far as elections are concerned. And one of the restrictions put there was that no ad hoc appointments was to be done. Now, similarly, in the manual of the Election Code of Conduct, that is 5.8.1, it has been stated by the Election Commission that the Model Code envisages that during the period of its operation, no ad hoc appointments in government, public undertakings shall be made which may have the effect of influencing the voters in favor of the party in power. Now the appointment that has been done, can you give me that please? Now the appointment of these two deputy chief ministers, the appointment which has been done of appointing the two deputy CMs is an ad hoc appointment done by the General Administration Department of the Government of Goa. This is an appointment which can be set aside with a stroke of a pen. This appointment is in direct violation of the Election Code of Conduct 5.8, Part 5.8 of the Election Code of Conduct, when no such ad hoc appointments can be made. The Election Commission is quite straight about it. Now 5.8.3, the Election Commission further states that normally the government, the party in power, should not make any ad hoc appointments if those appointments can wait till the completion of the election process. I'll just read it. Normally, wherever the Election Commission considers that the matter is not of extreme urgency and could wait till the completion of the election process, it advises the government to defer such appointment for the time being. So basically, what was the urgency for the government to appoint these two deputy CMs? Couldn't have this have waited till the completion of election process? Now this entire process was done basically to curry favor with certain voters amongst the electorate, and this is a complete violation of the Election Code of Conduct 5.8.3, which we have pointed out in our complaint to the Election Commission. Now the Election Commission has in fact in several instances enumerated in 5.9 in the manual of the Code of Conduct, has stated that they have in fact stopped governments from in fact announcing new districts in the constituency, stopped other administrative decisions being taken, appointments in certain in scheduled caste and OBC commissions have also been stopped by the Election Commission. Now this is an appointment that has been done of the deputy CMs during the time of when the Election Code of Conduct was in force. Now this is an important issue. This is a test for the Election Commission as to what action they will take on the complaint filed by us. Now there is also another issue that the Election Commission also has to look in, is the aspect regarding the allocation of portfolios amongst the ministers. Now the allocation of portfolios amongst the ministers comes under the business rules, government business rules. It's an administrative decision. And this decision also has an effect of influencing the voters, and it is also hit by 5.8 of the Election Model Code of Conduct of the Election Commission of India. Now we have filed this complaint before the Election Commission. We expect the Election Commission to look into our complaint with all seriousness and take a decision whether there has been violation of the Model Code of Conduct as alleged by us in our complaint, that is in respect of the appointment of the two deputy CMs, and also to suo moto look into whether the allocation of portfolios also violates 5.8 of the Model Code of Conduct. Now this is the issue that the Election Commission has to look into. This has been sent to the Election Commission of India. The chief election officer in Goa has been emailed to both these persons. Hard copy has also been served on the chief election officer in Goa. So we are looking forward to see what action, what decision is being taken on our complaint. Now, we expect a decision expeditiously on our complaint because some decision has to be taken before the election results are announced. The allocation of business amongst the ministers, allocation of portfolios under the business rules. Now, this has all been done under the business rules, allocation of portfolios during the time when the election code of conduct was in force. Wasn't it incumbent on the party in power to take permission of the Election Commission of India before the portfolios could have been allotted? It was as simple as that. The Election Commission of India is accessible to all the parties. Permission should have been taken for a waiver to say that the portfolios have to be allocated as government business is getting affected. And the Election Commission could, in all fairness, could have decided whether it was necessary or not, or whether the allocation of portfolios would have an effect of influencing the voters or not. The Election Commission could have taken a decision, because finally, the Election Commission has to see that there is a level playing field amongst all political parties.
They have not taken permission.
To our knowledge, no.
Okay.